गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस द थ्योरम दैट इज द आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल थ्योरम. सो लेट्स सी आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल थ्योरम. व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल थ्योरम? इफ टू साइड्स ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट, देन द एंगल अपोजिट टू देम आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट. हियर लेट अस कंसिडर ट्रायंगल. हियर ए बी सी इज एनी ट्रायंगल. ABC is any triangle. And what is the theorem says that? What is the given here? That given is that ABC is any isosceles triangle. ABC is any isosceles triangle. Here this ABC is any isosceles triangle means AB is congruent to AC. In this theorem it is given. We have to prove that the angle opposite to this congruent sides are congruent, because the statement of theorem is that if these two sides of triangles are congruent, then the angle opposite to them are congruent. So let's see. Given is that in triangle ABC, we write here in triangle ABC it is isosceles triangle. So we write here AB is equal to AC, or AB is congruent to AC. Okay, this is our given. Now here we have to prove that angle opposite these sides are congruent. Means here we have to prove that angle ABC is congruent to angle ACP. So we write here angle ABC is congruent to angle ACP. That we have here to prove. Now for this, if we want to prove these two angles, that is these base angles are congruent, for this we need to construction. So we here write a construction. What is our construction? We draw here angle bisector for this angle BAC, means this angle A. So we bisect this angle. Suppose this is the bisector which intersects at point here D. This is bisector. So these two angles are congruent. Because this is the bisector. So here we write draw bisector of angle BAC. BAC. We draw a bisector BAC which intersect BC at point D. Which intersect BC at point D. Here this bisector is intersect BC at point D. Now let's go ahead, that is prove. Now proof of this theorem. We have to prove that this angle ABC is congruent to angle ACB. Now for this, let us consider from figure we consider here two triangles. Okay, so first triangle is ABD and second triangle is ACB. In triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Okay, we consider these two triangles. Now we write here the congruent part of these two triangles. So here we know that AB is congruent to AC. It is already given because it is isosceles triangle. So we write here side AB is congruent to side, which side? Yes, side AC. And what we write here in this bracket? Yes, we write it given. This thing is given. So we write here given AB is congruent to side AC. Now second one is angle BAD. This is the congruent part. So we write here angle BAD is congruent to angle CAD. Why we write here these two angles are congruent? What is the reason for this?
Yes, the reason is that construction. Because we constructed that AD is the bisector of angle BAC. Bisector means it divides it into two equal parts. So we write here angle BAD is congruent to CAD, and reason is by construction. By construction. Okay. Now again, if we want to prove that these two triangles are congruent, for this again one thing is necessary to be congruent. Here, if we observe these two triangles. If we observe these two triangles, here AD is the common. AD is the common side, because AD is present in angle ABD and AD is present in angle ACD. So we can write here AD is a common side. So we write here side AD is congruent to side again AD. Why? What is the reason for this? Because the reason is that it is a common side. It is a common side. Now here three corresponding part of one triangle is congruent to three corresponding part of second triangle. It means that these two triangles are congruent, and so we write that these two triangles are congruent. I erase this given and to prove, and write here this triangle ABD, ABD is congruent to triangle second triangle is that ACD. And what is here? Test is the property. Yes, by observing we see that the property is side angle side, that is SAS test. So we write here by using SAS test, these two triangles are congruent. These two triangles are congruent. And if two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding parts are also congruent. So we can write here their corresponding part ABD. Therefore, angle ABD is congruent to angle, which angle? ACD. ACD. Why? Because CACT. CACT. That is corresponding angle of congruent triangle. Okay. This is nothing but the corresponding angle. These are the corresponding angle. Means in ABD, ABD is congruent to ACD. Means this angle B is congruent to this C. Corresponding angles of congruent triangle CACT. We can write these two angles are congruent. And from this, if these two angles are congruent, then from this we can say that this angle ABC. Therefore, angle ABC is congruent to angle, which angle? That is ACB. Here name are different. Name are different. But here angle are the same. Name are different, but angle are the same. That is ABD is, that is ABC. Because here BBC, because D is on the BC. Can write here angle ABC is congruent to angle ABC is congruent to angle ACD, and this is the proof of this theorem. Okay, this is the proof of this theorem. What is the theorem? Says that if two sides of triangles are congruent, then the opposite angles, the angle opposites to these sides are congruent. And hence, in this manner, we prove this theorem. So, write down this theorem in your notebook, and also write down the converse of isosceles triangle theorem in your notebook for practice.